back, guys. Welcome to episode 17 of Private Lesson. For those of you that are joining me for the discussion bar chat, welcome. Ask all the questions you want. I'll be chatting with you guys and hanging out with you guys while we watch this video. For those of you that are watching this later on and didn't join the chat, what I'm talking about is Discussion Bar is the sponsor of this video. What it is, it's a Google Chrome extension that you guys can download in literally 2 seconds. And what it does is it allows you to sync up with your friends and watch the YouTube videos together, and you guys can chat while watching the YouTube video simultaneously. It's not like YouTube comments that are posted after the fact, and for me it's very hard to get back to you guys. This is actually live. We're all going to be watching the video together, and it just makes it kind of cool interact. It's like you're at the movie theater together watching it. This episode I'm working with Daniel and Matthew, and we're working really big braking bumps coming into a turn, and these braking bumps were super wet as well. So we were trying to get them to just keep the bike as light as possible, not brake too aggressive, because a lot of the guys coming into the turn were getting super aggressive front end knife. So just trying to keep the bike light and float into the turn. We had my buddy Tyler Stepik there demonstrating a couple times through, John Bolin, Loretta's champ, 40 plus? I think 40 plus champ at Loretta's, went 1-1-1 this year. He was doing a couple passes as well, almost flew into the tree stump. Normally what I would teach is aggressive acceleration, aggressive deceleration, braking coming into the turn. You kind of have your braking zone is what I call it. In this situation, you're almost eliminating the braking zone or altering it. Then you want to come in and where you would normally be braking really, really hard, you want to get off the brake, off the rear brake, and just keep the bike light so you could float in the turn and avoid that front end knife. That's all. You guys can see, got the new, didn't even put it on the website. I don't know why. Didn't really have time to, but this is like a rose colored, pretty cool, rose color crew neck. If you guys want me to put this on the website, just comment below. I got about 50 of these things, so I can throw them on the site if you guys are interested, but I don't know, I like it myself. And then we got these hats, so they're not labeled yet, but kind of cool. I'm gonna have these hats in white and black. This was a test hat that was sent blank, but I'm gonna have these done with the Academy logo as well. Those will be up on the website as well. As always, thank you guys for viewing, subscribing, commenting below. Keep them coming. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. Very close to 20,000 subscribers at 20,000 mark. Gonna do something cool, gonna give away something. I'll figure that out when the time comes. And for you guys that did this live chat, I appreciate your support, and let's get this thing rolling.
Actually, you're doing exactly what I thought you would do, which is good. You're riding aggressive and you're trying to charge in. These braking bumps are big, first of all, so you have to approach them mentally a little bit different than you normally would. Not only are they big, they're wicked slippery. Now, what I would do different in this set, normally you have your hard acceleration point, you have your hard aggressive braking zone, and then you're into a turn. And you're doing just that. You come in super aggressive, you're braking really aggressive, and then you're taking turns. Problem with that is you're braking the most aggressive right in the 3 or 4 biggest bumps and the most slippery part. So what do you feel happening when you do that? You're getting a lot of front end instability, right? You're like knifing and tucking the front. It's because you're putting all of that load to the front and the big rollers and the crazy slick, so it's just like yanking your bars out of your hands. What I do here when it gets this slippery, or it doesn't have to be slippery, it could just be giant braking bumps in general, is you want to keep the bike light and almost accelerate in a way through the bump. So the way I would approach this, and you could probably do the same, is rather than coming up over that roller and accelerating wide open, so by the time you get here, you're forced to brake to slow yourself down. Honestly, I would just go like half throttle or go a moderate speed that you can just maintain all the way until the roller. Because you want to keep the bike light right here. But what that's going to do is it's going to create essentially zero braking zone for you. So I know it sounds like backwards things. Now, he's actually doing a good job of that. First of all, he's missing the bumps, which I want you to go in the bumps just for practice purposes. But he's going one speed the whole way, and his bike's staying nice and light. And it just, he's not getting that aggressive front end knife. If he were to go through the bumps, I bet you he could handle them just fine. And then he just kind of carries that momentum into a turn. What's nice is it is a sand berm, so you can kind of just fly in there with more momentum than you're used to. What you don't want to do is now move your braking zone to after the stump, because then you got to worry about turning. So we're basically just going to eliminate the braking zone altogether. Like him, I mean, that's great. I don't know if he's doing it on purpose, but he doesn't even touch his rear brake the whole time.
Yeah.
I don't think he's doing it intentionally, but let's get you doing it intentionally. Come through, nice and smooth, no brakes at all, just flow into that turn. It's going to feel a little weird, but you're not going to get that front end knife there. So what Daniel's dealing with right now, pretty good sized braking bumps and wet. I'm talking, this is really, really greasy. This is Matthew, by the way. Just so we know who the camera's on. Okay, what you were doing a great job of, whether you realized it or not, is you weren't really accelerating super hard and forcing yourself to brake super hard.
Yeah.
You were just kind of going one gradual speed through.
That.
In normal situations, I would say that's not how you ride. You're supposed to ride aggressive on the throttle and then aggressive braking, and then you're into the turn. But with it being so bumpy in the main line and just so slick altogether, if you brake super aggressive coming in, you're gonna start to really wash the front. But you were in, I think, it sounded maybe like third gear, and you're just all the way right into the turn. Didn't touch your rear brake at all, which in this situation is actually really good. Don't form a habit of that everywhere on the track, because it's not gonna work.
Yeah.
But in this situation, it helps you just flow in the turn. So that's what that's the exact advice I actually gave him.
Right when I'm entering, I give it a little front brake, but then I let off.
And you just have to be really careful of front brake, because it's sandy, it's slippery, you can use it, but you just gotta be really careful with it.
I'm trying to get farther forward. I feel like I'm not.
One thing I would do for you, and I'll film you in the turn a couple times so people watching on YouTube can see, your inside foot is really sloppy. Every time you put it out, it grabs the ground. So I'm gonna tell you, just leave it on the foot peg.
Okay.
Try to scoot up a little further in the seat, relax your upper body, because this is sand we're dealing with, so you don't want to be just doing this and having your butt forward, remember that. And then just leave your inside foot
on the foot.
It'll just create less mistakes. Coming through here, your inside line's good, but let's try going through the rough stuff, just to get a feel of what that's like. Use the same technique of your attack position's good. Keep the attack position, just be nice and smooth. Let's see how you're doing.
Like where he's going?
Yeah, even further right, if you can. He's doing the same thing as you in the turn, too. I know it's sandy and it's unpredictable, and every lap you come, it's a little bit different. But we need to get out of the habit of dabbing that inside foot. Keep it light! There we go. Solid. Elbows. Where is he sitting? There you go. Sit up on the seat. Up on the seat. There you go. Not bad. You weren't dabbing it that bad, but also it's like here.
Yeah.
Remember, your foot is either so high and tight that you're almost making contact with your fender, or just leave it on the pegs. You're doing a good job of leaving on the pegs, but just remember that you have to cover that front green rib on your seat with your butt. See, and he's doing it good too, other than foot position. Foot position, his elbow is dropping a little bit as well.
Is it okay?
And trust me, that's one thing I would be guilty of. And we want to eliminate one hard acceleration as well. Want a one time smooth on the gas. Elbows! Holy cow, that's what an elbow drop will do to you. Full head movement and then knife the front. Smooth! the harder Daniel accelerates here, the harder it kicks him out of the rut, and then all of a sudden he's unsettled. The smoother you can be, the more your bike will stick, because there's subtle bumps the whole way through here.
Oh! Wow!
Okay, that's why inside elbow is important, even a straightaway, because with how slick it is, you can so easily get that front end knife. See, you got even got a little... Do what?
Subscribe to my channel.
What's your channel?
Tyler Steffick.
Do you have a video?
Yeah, remember Supercross, the most riding.
Oh, so you have one video?
Yeah, from a year or two ago. I'll put more if they want.
Okay. Alright, so the more you rode it, the more you were kind of dropping your elbows and like sitting down too early. Were you getting
I was getting like the one time I hit that and it kicked me forward and
so first few were really good, and then they sort of got worse and worse from there. I'm like, I was thinking to myself, is he getting tired or what's happening? So maybe you had that little scare and you just started to slow down in this last part of the straightaway, and you going just that little bit slower was screwing up the whole straightaway. Because what it was doing is you going a little slower, everything was falling to the front of the bike, and next thing you know, you were getting like really aggressive twitches. Which is making you like almost knife the front end and crash every 2 seconds. Carry a little bit more speed, just like you were before. The bike's gonna float across. All it is at this point is piecing the puzzle pieces together. That's it. So we got keep the bike nice and light, come into the turn, sit in the correct part of the seat, keep the elbows up, keep the foot on the peg. Repetition. If you could get 10 out of 10, that's what we want to see. We don't want to see you light the world on fire for one and then mess up the other 9, right? Kind of same thing for you that I just told him. Your first 2 or 3 or 4 were really good, and I don't know if you started to get tired or if the section was getting more difficult, you started to go a little slower, and what it was doing is you were actually starting to knife the front a little bit more coming in. Your inside foot in the turn is really just bad. Leave it on the foot peg. And that goes for you people watching, that goes for you, that goes for you. If your foot is not going to be touching the front fender, it's so high and tight, do not even bother taking it off the foot peg. Form a habit of just leaving it on the pegs. In 2 or 3 years, you're going to be thanking me. Every time you come through, whoop, your foot dabs the ground. He was accelerating too hard, too quick at the beginning, and what didn't it feel like? It was kind of like, and it was actually bouncing you up and out. It's a sandy turn, so it's kind of forming like Southwick does, where it's got just rollers throughout the whole turn from people accelerating hard and using the clutch at different points in the turn. The way to combat that, a bumpy turn like that in the sand, is to be as smooth as possible. The more you're rough, the more your bike is going to react to it. So like the first 3 or 4, you were really whacking the throttle at the beginning. Then you had a couple after that when I really felt smooth. I swear, every time I yell something, you seem to fix whatever it was I was yelling about, but you can never hear what I'm actually saying. I was yelling smooth, and those next 2 or 3, you were rolling the throttle on nice and easy, and your bike was staying more glued to the bike. All right, bud catcher, enough dodging the camera. Let's see how you do it.
All right.
So third gear's key.
Third gear's better. Where you were messing up and you almost killed yourself. Yeah, well, it's because your inside elbow does this, and your whole body starts to fall inside of the bike.
Okay.
Body too much? Yeah, you're leaning inside of the bike half of that straightaway.
God,
the foot dab.
I know, my foot dabs are hard. I mean, hard.
With how slippery it is right here, you have to focus so much on just staying centered with the bike, or even lean the bike inside of you and keep your body upright when you're standing. You were falling inside of it.
I remember falling in that tree one time.
So that's the key of a good rider, is watch from his waist up, it does like nothing. His legs and knees and hips are doing all the work, this is doing nothing. That's why he's so good. That one, he started to fall inside of it.